שלום וברכה מוריי ורבותיי, שלום וברכה בעזרת השם בזכות הצדיק רבי חיים פינטו, בזכות כל הצדיקים שהקדוש ברוך הוא בעזרת השם בלס אור הולי קהילה וברכה והצלחה בסייעתא דשמיא גדולה והקדמה מרוויח את כל נזקי תקון בזכות הצדיק רבי חיים פינטו הקדוש ברוך הוא בעזרת השם להבדגית הפרנסה, הנגית ישועה, הנגית התורה, הנגית הרפואה מהקדוש ברוך הוא בעזרת השם מספיר לנו הולי קהילה שפע עד בלי די ולא פרס בי אקספטד ברצון מהקדוש ברוך הוא בעזרת השם give us the merit to taste the taste of גאולה, the taste of redemption in our mouth throughout the entire year בעזרת השם. הנה בתי ברוך השם right now we're ממש just a few days after Purim. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu extend the light of Purim and extend the happiness of Purim, that Be'ezrat Hashem will celebrate the entire year kula with happiness and with simcha, and May HaKadosh Baruch Hu will make a miracle of an afochu, that all our negative, all our sufferings, all our pain that a person has throughout his entire life will flip to complete happiness, to complete rejoice, to complete celebration. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
In this week's parasha, we have a very, very interesting parasha that we could learn a lot of how we should all perform in our day-to-day life throughout our ups and throughout our downs. As we now brought in this week's parasha, we read about the terrible thing that Bnei Israel did with the sin of the Egel Azav, with the golden calf. That as we know, this sin actually brought Bnei Israel back to the world, to the point where it was after the sin. Whereas we know that Adam Rishon sinned, right after Adam Rishon sinned, there were many hundreds of years of the world being in an unstable place. Bnei Israel went down to Egypt, fixed the world, brought the world back to its place after the sin, meaning no sin existed.
Mm-hmm.
And then here in this week's parasha, Bnei Israel repeat a mistake, repeat a sin, and we bring the world back to its form of destruction that till today we're trying to fix, till today we're trying to repair. As we now brought out with the Midrash, and the Gemara, and the Zohar Kadosh says, that Bnei Israel's sin of the golden calf, it was not a sin that they did for sin. It was a sin that they did actually for Bnei Israel in the future generations. Or the Midrash says that Bnei Israel sinned with one thought in mind. The thought was simple. Until now, all the sins that people committed, it was the sins of an individual. One individual person got up, he sinned. Zero. Bnei Israel knew that until this point forward, everybody knows that a repairing of a singular person's sin is possible. But until that point, it wasn't clear whether or not if a nation sin, if repents is possible. That until that point, it wasn't something that occurred that many people together, or half a nation, almost an entire nation, came together and sinned in one sin. Bnei Israel wanted to prove that there is place for repents, even if multiple people sin together. So this Rabbatai brings us to something that happened right after Bnei Israel performed the sin. The Midrash said that Bnei Israel started to cry. So the question that we've asked this morning, what was the motivation and what was the reason that Bnei Israel crying after performing a sin that they did to teach a lesson for future generations? So in Rabbatai, we were thinking about this and it brought us to a thought between the difference of tears of Bnei Israel and Umot HaOlam, the difference between the tears of a Jew and the tears of a non-Jew. So it brought us to a very beautiful thought. Maybe we can all help us to go through hard times in our life and help us to keep our head in the right direction all the time. In our time, when a non-Jew sits down and he cries, we're thinking to ourselves, what is the motivation behind his tears? Why is he crying? And it brought us to a very simple thought. When a non-Jew cries, his tears are tears of Yeush. What does Yeush mean? They are tears of a man that has given up. Tears of a man that is mourning. Tears of a man that broke something and now he's trying to cope with the loss that came to his hands. They are tears of a person that is in a low place that is expressing his pain and his sorrow. The tears of Bnei Israel are actually completely different. The tears of Bnei Israel are what? They are tears of hope. That when a Jew cries, it's not tears of mourning or tears of lack of hope. It's tears of hope that HaKadosh Baruch Hu will come forward and he will help and he will redeem from our troubles. That when a Jew cries, he's actually breaking himself and bringing himself to his minimum, purest form of his own entity. And with that, calling the help of HaKadosh Baruch Hu with hope that he will help and he will guide us and he will redeem us and he will bring us to a point of redemption. then that is the difference. When a non-Jew cries, it's tears of lack of hope and tears of mourning. And when a Jew cries, it's tears of hope. And that about that is something that is so beautiful about Am Yisrael. Regardless of what is lost, regardless of what is broken, regardless of what we are going through, we never cry, we never go into a bad place of just giving up and lifting our hands, and that's why we are crying. Always and throughout all our troubles, we have it embedded within our soul that we sit down and we cry, not as a form of mourning, but a form of gathering ourselves, as gathering our strength and preparing for a Gewula. And this Abotai is something we can see with Yirmiyahu HaNavi. You know, Yirmiyahu HaNavi was a big prophet. It said that when Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, he was sitting on the steps of Beit HaMikdash and he was crying. And a big philosophy, a big smart non-Jew walked by. So he sees Yirmiyahu and he said, Yirmiyahu is a big prophet, why is he crying? So he walked up to Yirmiyahu, he said, Yirmiyahu, I hear about you that you are a big, holy man, very intelligent man, man of miracles. Why are you crying? What, for a group of pile of stones? For a building that broke down, for a building that broke, that was destroyed. That's why you are crying, such a man that is all about his knowledge and all about his prophecy. So Yirmiyahu looked at this man and he answered him a very simple answer. He said, you know, even if I was to explain to you why I am crying, you would never understand. Why is that? So he said, maybe we can say that the tears of the Jew is so unique that they represent complete hope that a non-Jew will never be able to understand. Tears of complete hope. And that's what Abba we see in the sixth parasha. Bnei Yisrael cry after the golden calf, not as tears of mourning what is lost, but of a way of gathering the strength and proving to all of us, look, there is hope. We can repent. We can fix. That's what Abba Tai we need to hold on every single day in our life. Regardless of what we lose, regardless of what we break, regardless of what mistakes we do, a person can never come to a place of Yeush. Yeush is the Sitra Acha. Yeush is the evil inclination. Yeush is Klipat HaMalek that we read there 2 weeks ago. Yeush, Rabotai, is the biggest Yetzara that exists. When a person comes and he completely gives up on his state, that is Yetzara. A person needs to learn, regardless of what is lost, nothing is ever lost. There is always hope for repentance, there's always hope to fix, there's always hope to bring upon ourselves better days of Shefa and of Simcha. And that's what we say every single day in the Tefillah. When a person prays, Kaveh El Hashem, when a person prays to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and he sees his prayer not going to where it's supposed to be and the prayer is not being accepted, don't give up. What should you do? Gather your heart, Chazek, strengthen your heart, Kaveh El Hashem. And you pray again to HaKadosh Baruch. And that is the secret of Am Yisrael. We never give up. We never lose hope. We never lose our direction. Regardless of what we go through in our life, we always find the way to get up, to strengthen ourselves, to strengthen the hope in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and to get to work to fix. And that's what Abba Tai, we have to encourage everyone. We should never lose hope in everything. No matter what a person he did in his life, where he stands in his life, there is always hope for reparation. There is always hope for repentance. In the midst of all tzaddikim, in the midst of the holy holiday that we just passed, give us always the koach and the simcha and the shefa to never lose hope and to always strengthen ourselves for the upcoming redemption. Amen.
Amen.